हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ रुचि कौशिक शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, बाबू बनारसी दास, नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, लखनऊ. सो टूडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ आइगन वैल्यूज़ एंड आइगन वैक्टर्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. आइगन वैल्यूज़ एंड आइगन वैक्टर्स प्ले ए प्रोमिनेंट रोल इन द स्टडी ऑफ ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन and in many applications in the physical sciences. So this is the definition of eigenvalue. Let A be an n by n matrix. The number lambda is an eigenvalue of A if there exists a non-zero vector x such that Ax is equals to lambda x. So in this case, vector x is called eigenvector corresponding to lambda, and this lambda is known as eigenvalue. So this equation can be written in this form: A minus lambda I is equals to 0, and x can be written in this way. Suppose we have a matrix A is equals to A11, A12 up to A1n, A21, A22 up to A2n, AN1, AN2 up to ANn, which is a n by n matrix. So A minus lambda I can be written in this form. This is a matrix A minus lambda of identity matrix I, or we can write this A minus lambda I, A minus lambda I is equals to A11 minus lambda A12 up to A1n, then A21, A22 minus lambda up to A2n. In this manner, the all diagonal entries is subtracted by lambda. So, and if we multiply by x, and there is a n by 1 column vector. So, x is a n by 1 vector. So, the equation, the eigenvalues are also called characteristic values, proper values, or latent values. These are other names for eigenvalues. So, next one, what is a characteristic matrix? This matrix A minus lambda I is known as characteristic matrix. Suppose we have an example here. Suppose A is equals to 2 2 1, 1 3 1, 1 2 2. This is first row, second, third. Now I want to write its characteristic matrix. So first of all, we have to write A minus lambda I, which is equals to matrix A minus lambda times identity matrix, which is equals to 2 minus lambda 2 1 1 3 minus lambda 1 1 2 2 minus lambda. So you can see the diagonal entries is subtracted by lambda. This matrix is called characteristic matrix. Now next one is characteristic polynomial. Now suppose we have this matrix. So, now I want to solve this matrix in the terms of lambda. So, we can solve, we know how to find determinant of this matrix. A minus lambda I determinant is equals to, in the determinant form, 2 minus lambda 2 1 1 3 minus lambda 1 1 2 2 minus lambda, which is equals to 2 minus lambda. Now, you have to solve the 2 by 2 minor by deleting first row and first column. So, we have here 3 minus lambda 2 minus lambda minus 2. Next one is minus 2. Now, we have to multiply this by this, which is 2 minus lambda minus 1. Next one plus 1, 2 minus 3 plus lambda. Now, you can solve this algebraic equation in the terms of lambda. So, we will get, which is equals to 2 minus lambda. Now, we have to multiply these two brackets. So, this is 6 minus 5 lambda plus lambda square minus 2 minus 2 1 minus lambda plus 1 lambda minus 1. 2 minus 3 is equals to minus 1. So, you can write lambda minus 1, which is equals to 2 minus lambda lambda square minus 5 lambda minus 1 minus 2 1 minus lambda plus lambda minus 1. Now, again we can write here it is equals to 2 lambda square minus 10 lambda minus 2 minus lambda cube plus 5 lambda square plus lambda minus 2 plus 2 lambda plus lambda minus 1. Now, we can arrange in descending powers of lambda. So, first of all, this is minus lambda cube. Now, lambda square, which is equals to plus 7 lambda square. Now, lambda, this is lambda, this is lambda, this is lambda. So, 10 minus 4 lambda, which is equals to 6 lambda, and minus 3. So, this equation, this polynomial in lambda is called characteristic polynomial. Okay. Now, this is equals to lambda square minus 5 lambda plus 4 minus 2 1 minus lambda plus lambda minus 1. Now, this is equals to 2 lambda square minus 10 lambda plus 8 minus lambda cube plus 5 lambda square minus 4 lambda minus 2 plus 2 lambda plus lambda minus 1. Now, we can arrange in the powers of lambda, which is equals to minus lambda cube. Now, for lambda square, which is equals to plus 7 lambda square, then for lambda and this one. So, we can write minus 11 lambda and then 8 minus 2 is 6 minus 1 is 5 plus 5. So, this equation is called characteristic polynomial, or we can write it is equals to P lambda, is equals to P lambda. This is characteristic equation of matrix A. Now, next definition is this is characteristic polynomial for matrix A. Now, next definition is characteristic equation. If this determinant is equals to 0, if A minus lambda I is equals to 0, then it is called characteristic equation of the matrix A. Suppose, if we write this P lambda is equals to 0, then we will get minus lambda cube plus 7 lambda square minus 11 lambda plus 5, it is equals to 0, or we can write it lambda cube minus 7 lambda square plus 11 lambda minus 5 is equals to 0. This is called characteristic equation, and previous one this is called characteristic polynomial. So, by solving this characteristic equations, we will get some roots. Since this is a cubic equation, so you will get 3 roots. So, these roots are called characteristic roots or eigen values. So, we can solve this cubic polynomial or cubic equation just by, first of all you have to solve it by Hilton trial method. So, or we can solve it by synthetic division also. So, first of all you have to check if lambda is equals to 1 is its root or not, by minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3 and so on. You have to check what is the root of this equation. So, suppose we are checking it for lambda is equals to 1. So, we can see here 1, 1 minus 7 plus 11 minus 5, which is equals to 0, 12 minus 12, which is equals to 0. So, lambda equal to 1 is a root of this equation. So, now you have to divide this polynomial by lambda minus 1, and we will get lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 5. You can check by multiplying. First of all, lambda cube minus 6 lambda square minus lambda square will be equals to minus 7 lambda square, then 5 lambda minus 6 lambda. You can check it easily. So, now next definition is characteristic equation. Suppose we have this characteristic polynomial. If we put this characteristic polynomial is equals to 0, then we will get characteristic equation. So, we can write minus lambda cube plus 7 lambda square, 7 lambda square minus 11 lambda and plus 5 is equals to 0, then this equation is called characteristic equation, or we can write it in this form: lambda cube minus 7 lambda square plus 11 lambda minus 5 is equals to 0. So, this is a characteristic equation, and as all of you know how to solve a cubic polynomial. So, the roots of this equation is known as characteristic roots or eigenvalues. So, now by solving this cubic polynomial, we can get the characteristic roots or eigenvalues of this characteristic equation. Now, you can check that lambda is equals to 1 is root of this equation. So, first of all, we have to check by hit and trial method that lambda is equals to 1 is its root or not. If not, then you have to check for minus 1, or you have to check for 2, for minus 2, for 3, minus 3, and so on, and you will get the root of this equation. Or you can use a synthetic division method for solving a cubic polynomial. Now, we have to check here for lambda is equals to 1, and we can see 1 minus 7 plus 11 minus 5 is equals to 0, since 12 minus 12 is equals to 0. So, lambda is equals to 1 is a root of this polynomial. Okay? Now, you can divide by lambda minus 1, and we will get lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 5 is equals to 0. You can check by multiplying these two polynomials that you will get this polynomial. So, now we can easily solve this polynomial: lambda square minus 5 lambda minus lambda plus 5 is equals to 0. And we will get roots are lambda minus 1, lambda minus 1, and lambda minus 5, which is equals to 0. So, we will get 3 values for lambda 1, comma 1, comma 5. These are the eigen values for the matrix A. So, now some important properties of eigenvalues. Suppose A is an square matrix and A transpose is A dash. So, the eigenvalues of A and eigenvalues of A dash will be same. Next one is the sum of the eigenvalues of a matrix is equal to the trace of the matrix. Suppose, and what is trace? Trace can be defined as the sum of all diagonal entries. Sum of all diagonal entries is known as trace of a matrix. You can see here what is the sum of these diagonal entries. 2 plus 3 plus 2 is equals to 7. And here we have these eigenvalues 1, 1, 5. So, what is this equals to? 5 plus 1 plus 1 is equals to 7. So, now you can say that the sum of the eigenvalues of a matrix is equals to the trace of the matrix. Next one, the product of the eigenvalues of a matrix A is equals to the determinant of A. Suppose you have, again you have the same matrix, and you all of you know how to determine determinant of a matrix. It is a lengthy process, and you can calculate easily how to find determinant of a matrix. But if you have eigenvalues, then you can write directly what is the determinant. You can write it 1 into 1 into 5 which is equals to 5. So, determinant of this matrix will be 5. So, this is an application of eigenvalues. So, with the help of eigenvalues, you can say directly what will be the determinant of a square matrix. Next one is, if suppose you have n eigenvalues for n cross n square matrix, they are lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n, then you have to find what is eigenvalues of k into A. Suppose you have, first of all, you have matrix 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and someone asking what will be the eigenvalues for this matrix. Suppose you have 10 to power 5 10 raised to power 5. So, if you know what are the eigenvalues of this matrix, then directly you can say what will be the eigenvalues of this matrix A raised to power 5, suppose this is. So, or you may give this name is B. So, just multiplying it by k. So, what is k here? K is equals to 10 raised to power 5. So, if this matrix have eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n, then the eigenvalues of this matrix will be 10 raised to power 5 lambda 1, 10 raised to power 5 lambda 2, and 10 raised to power 5 lambda n. And second one, if you want to find, suppose you want to find eigenvalues for A raised to power m, suppose you have matrix A and whose eigenvalues are lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n, then now you have to find the eigenvalues of A raised to power 5, then they will be lambda 1 raised to power 5, lambda 2 raised to power 5 up to lambda n raised to power 5. And you can also find the eigenvalues for A inverse. If A have eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n, then you can say the eigenvalues for A inverse will be 1 upon lambda 1, 1 upon lambda 2, and 1 upon lambda n. So, these are the very important applications for eigenvalues. You can use them in typical problems of matrices, and these properties will make it an easy problem to solve. So, now suppose we have this matrix 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and we have to find its eigenvalues. So, let us start. Suppose it is equals to A, which is equals to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It is a 3 by 3 matrix. Now, first of all, in step 1, you have to write A minus lambda I, or we can say, first of all, we have to write its characteristic matrix, which is equals to, now all of you know how to write a characteristic matrix for a matrix, which is equals to this. Now, with the help of this characteristic matrix, we can write its characteristic polynomial by putting this matrix into determinant form. And by after writing characteristic polynomial, you can write characteristic equation by putting this polynomial is equals to 0. So, we will get here 1 minus lambda. So, we will get and 1 minus lambda square minus 1, then minus 1 with 1 minus lambda minus 1, then plus 1. And you will get 1 minus 1 minus lambda, so it will be plus lambda. So 1 cancel out with 1, this 1 with this 1, and you will get 1 minus lambda, this is 1 minus 2 lambda plus lambda square minus 1, this is minus into minus plus, which is equals to plus lambda, and here you also have plus lambda. So, which is equals to, and we can put it is equals to 0, it is equals to 0. So, 1 minus lambda is lambda square minus 2 lambda plus 2 lambda, which is equals to 0, or we can write lambda square minus 2 lambda minus lambda cube plus 2 lambda square plus 2 lambda, which is equals to 0, and this 2 lambda will be cancel out. So, it will be equals to minus lambda cube plus 3 lambda square is equals to 0, or we can write minus lambda square is common and lambda minus 3 is equals to 0. So, we get here these eigenvalues 0, 0, 3. So, the eigenvalues for this matrix will be 0, 0 and 3. So, 0, 0 is same. So, two eigenvalues are same here, and I will explain later that the repeating eigenvalues have algebraic multiplicity. So, if you want to say what is the algebraic multiplicity of lambda is equals to 0, then you can say algebraic multiplicity is equals to 2. These are two things, algebraic multiplicity and geometric multiplicity. The repetition of eigenvalues is known as algebraic multiplicity, and the repetition of eigenvectors is known as geometric multiplicity for eigenvalues and eigenvectors. In next lectures, I will explain about these two concepts. So, next, this is another application of eigenvalues. If you have eigenvalues for this matrix, then you can find the eigenvalues of a raised to power 25 or eigenvalues for a plus 2i. So, this is another applications of eigenvalues. So, first of all, you have to find the eigenvalues of this matrix 3, 0, 8, minus 1. Suppose this is equals to a. Now, first of all, we have to write a minus lambda I is equals to 3 minus lambda 0, 8 minus 1 minus lambda. Now, we have to find its determinant is equals to 0, which is known as characteristic equation of the matrix. So, you can write 3 minus lambda 0, 8 minus 1 minus lambda is equals to 0, and we all know how to solve this determinant by just cross multiply it and subtract. 3 minus lambda minus 1 minus lambda and minus 0 is equals to 0. So, we have here minus common, lambda plus 1, and 3 minus lambda is equals to 0. So, we will get lambda is equals to minus 1 and 3. These are the eigenvalues of this matrix A. This is A. Now, I have to find eigenvalues for a raised to power 25 and a plus 2i. So, as you know all these properties, you can say what will be the eigenvalues of a raised to power m. So, what they will be? They you can write the eigenvalues for a raised to power 25 will be minus 1 raised to power 25, comma 3 raised to power 25, and you can solve them easily. And for a plus 2i, the eigenvalues for a plus 2i will be minus 1 plus 2 comma 3 plus 2, which is equals to 1 comma 5. So, these are the applications for eigenvalues. Now, I am taking another example, and now I am very sure that now you have expertise in calculating eigenvalues, how to calculate eigenvalues. So, you can solve this matrix easily. Here the matrix is 1 minus 2, 3 minus 4. First of all, you have to write its characteristic matrix, then characteristic polynomial, then characteristic equation, then characteristic roots, all the four steps. This is just revision. Step 1, characteristic matrix. This is characteristic polynomial. This is characteristic equation. Then you will get characteristic roots, and these roots are called eigenvalues of the given matrix. Now, next concept is how to find eigenvectors, and what are the eigenvector? First question is that. So, in the equation A lambda or A x is equals to lambda x, the values of x is known as eigenvectors corresponding to that eigenvalue lambda. Suppose you have this matrix 1 minus 2, 3 minus 4, and x 1 x 2 is equals to minus 1, and here missing x 1 x 2. Suppose you have this equation in this form, A x is equals to lambda x. Firstly, you have to calculate the eigenvalues, and all of you know how to calculate eigenvalues for the given matrix. Suppose this is equals to minus 1. So, first of all, you have to write this equation in this form. Now, you can solve simultaneous equation. This is non-homogeneous simultaneous equation. In previous lecture, we have studied about how to solve simultaneous equation. They are of two types, homogeneous and non-homogeneous. This is a non-homogeneous simultaneous equation because the right hand side is non-zero. So, we can solve it in this way. First of all, you have to write in equation form. So, x 1 minus 2 x 2 is equals to minus x 1, 3 x 1 minus 4 x 2 is equals to minus x 2. Now, we can see if we multiply, we are solving here x 1 coming here plus x 1, then it will become 2 x 1 minus 2 x 2 is equals to 0. Similarly, you can solve this equation 3 x 1 minus 3 x 2 is equals to 0. So, we can see something similar in these two equations. Suppose you are getting 2 out, or we are taking 2 common from this equation, what we will get? We will get x 1 minus x 2 is equals to 0. Same here, if we take common 3 from this equation, we will get x 1 minus x 2 is equals to 0. Okay? So, these two equations are same. So, as we studied previously that if we have the number of equations is less than the number of unknown variables, here the unknown variables are 2 and only a independent equation. So, how many solutions there exist? There will be infinite many solutions for this equation. So, after solving this equation, we will get a relation between x1 and x2. You can see these equations are not independent. So, you have to you will get infinite many solutions for this equation. So, we can write this equation in this form. Suppose x1 is 1, then you will get x2 is equals to 1 also. In similar way, if you write x1 is equals to 2, then x2 will become 2. If you write x1 is 3, then x2 will is equals to 3 and so on. So, I can write in general, I can write if x1 is equals to t, then x2 also is equals to t. And if we write in this form, in column form, then I can write t outside the column or this vector, this is 2 cross 1 vector, and we can write 1 1. In similar way, we have another eigenvectors 4 4 3000 3000. These are just some examples. You can write infinite many vectors for this, are the possible eigenvectors for eigenvalue -1. Okay, for -1 you have these type of eigenvectors. Now, next one, by solving this equation we get two eigenvalues. They are lambda equal to -1 and next one is lambda is equals to -2. Now, this for lambda is equals to -2, you have to again calculate the eigenvectors. What are the eigenvectors for this eigenvalue? So, again we repeat the procedure. We have to write A x is equals to lambda x. So, A x is equals to lambda x. Again, you can solve this in these simultaneous equations. x1 minus 2 x2 is equals to -2 x1, 3 x1 minus 4 x2 is equals to -2 x2. Again, we can solve and we will get two same equations, 3 x1 minus 2 x2 is equals to 0, and another one also equals to the equation 1. Again, we will get one equation and two variable. We have there also infinite many solution for this equation. So, we can write, if we will write it in this form, 3 x1 is equals to 2 x2, or we can see x2 is equals to 3 upon 2 x1. Now, suppose we are giving x1 the value 2, then x2 will be 3. So, you can write eigenvectors in this form, in a column vector form. So, it will be equal to t 2 3. So, we get eigenvectors for given eigenvalues. Again, there is another example. Find the eigenvalues and corresponding eigenvectors for this matrix A. What is the dimension of the eigenspace for each eigenvalue? So, first of all, you have to know what is a eigenspace. As in previous example, we have eigenvectors for lambda equal to -1 and for lambda is equals to -2. But can you say these eigenvectors are Li or not? Li eigenvectors or not? So, this is your tutorial problem. You have to check these eigenvectors are Li or not. And by meaning eigenspace, you can define it as the set of all eigenvectors including 0. The set of all eigenvectors, by putting 0 in the set, this form a space. And what is a vector space or subspace? You will learn it later, but just you have to know what is the definition of eigenspace here. So, the collection of all eigenvectors is known as eigenspace. Then what is the dimension? So, the number of Li vectors. So, number of Li eigenvectors in this eigenspace is known as dimension of this eigenspace. Okay. So, now you can see the given matrix is a upper triangular matrix. In our initial lectures, we have learned about the type of matrices. You have learned a lot about matrices, and all of you know very well what is a upper triangular matrix. The all off diagonal matrix entries of a matrix are 0. The all entries below this principal diagonal are 0. So, this matrix is known as upper triangular matrix. Now, we have to find its eigenvalues. So, first of all, you have to write characteristic equation for this matrix. So, we know this A minus lambda is equals to 0, or we can write it lambda I minus A. There is no effect on this equation. So, you can see just multiplying all the diagonal entries, you will get determinant of this matrix. If you have a upper triangular matrix or a lower triangular matrix, you just multiply the diagonal entries and you will get the determinant of the given matrix. So, we have these repeated eigenvalues for the given matrix. Now, corresponding to this eigenvalue, we have to find eigenvectors. So, as we done previously in previous example, in the same way you can find eigenvectors for this 3 cross 3 matrix. So, first of all you have to write it for lambda is equals to 2, that means this equation will become 2i minus a x. So, we will get this matrix is equals to 0. Now, what the simultaneous equations here? You can see 0 minus x 2 equals to 0, and you can find what is x 1, what is x 3. We are not able to find these two vectors. So, we just know what is x 2. So, x 2 is equals to 0. Suppose x 1 is s and x 3 is t. So, you can write eigenvectors in this form, or by splitting this in two, sum of two vectors, then you can write s 1 0 0 plus t 0 0 1. So, this will be the eigenspace for the matrix A corresponding to this eigenvalue lambda is equals to 2. So, by studying all these properties of eigenvalues, eigenvectors, you can apply them in further studies for diagonalization of a matrix, for similarity of matrices. These eigenvalue and eigenvectors are base for these concepts, and in next lectures we will study about how to diagonalize a matrix and what are the similar matrices. And there is another concept for Cayley-Hamilton theorem. In my next lecture, I will explain what is a Cayley-Hamilton theorem. So, if you have any query, then you can ask me, you can mail me on my email ID ruchikaushik07@bvdnitm.ac.in. Thank you very much.